Children, today we will be learning about water cycle. Water cycle is also known as hydrologic cycle or the hydrological cycle. The word hydro means water. Now, the water cycle, it shows the continuous movement of water on, above and below the surface of the earth. Now, there are three stages involved in water cycle: evaporation, condensation and precipitation. Water is always changing states between liquid vapors and ice, and this water cycle is continuously moving from millions of years in the same way. Now, as I told you, there are three stages, so let's start with the evaporation. Whenever we heat up the water changes into vapors. Similarly, due to sun's heat, the water lying in the water bodies like oceans, lakes and rivers, they evaporate. So, the process of changing water into water vapor is called evaporation. So now, as the water vapor rises up into the air, it starts cooling down and they form tiny water droplets. These droplets, they come together to form clouds, and this process is called condensation. So condensation is when the water vapors at high altitude cools down and forms water droplets. Again, they are changing the state from vapors, they are changing to water droplets. So this is called condensation. Now, in condensation, the clouds are formed. When the clouds start getting heavy and cannot hold the water droplets anymore, they fall back to earth in the form of rain, hail or snow. This is called precipitation. Moreover, due to air currents, the clouds keep on moving around the globe. They collide and fall out of the sky as precipitation. Some precipitation falls as snow and some accumulates as ice caps and glaciers. Most of the precipitation falls back into the ocean and river bodies. So hope you have understood the whole water cycle. It involves three stages: evaporation, condensation and precipitation. If you like the video, then don't forget to press the like button and do subscribe our channel for more such informative videos. Thank you.